It's the Don't Make It Weird podcast with your hosts, Daniel and Dinosaurus.
Oh, hello there. I didn't see you there. This is the Don't Make It Weird podcast, and this is episode number 46, and I'm one of your co-hosts, the 80s shock jock known as Daniel Quigley. How are you guys doing, man? We're so excited that you guys are here to join us on this podcast. I can't be that nice. I'm sorry. I tried to tone it down. I couldn't do it. I have to be excited. This is what I do. We've got an incredible show for you guys. But, you know, someone missing. Someone very near and dear to my heart. That would be my co-host. Because I am joined, as always, by the Azure Academic Agent of the Avila herself, Dinosaurus!
I was playing like the eye game. Hi. I was playing the eye game with my dog off screen. And like, I would look at him and then like, he would look away and then. No. It was supposed to be cute. You fucking weirdo.
So, hey, Dina, what's going on today? How are you? How's your hair?
It's not a good hair day. And I had something really funny to say about how I am today, but I don't remember what it was. So. Sorry.
I mean, was it about you making eye babies with your dog?
No. Oh, I feel like I'm wearing a shirt that has a stain on it, and I hope that the camera cuts it off because it's pretty bad.
Sean, can we just Photoshop an extra large stain on her?
I'm zooming in on the stain right now. I'm zooming in.
Perfect. Right. Excellent. That's exactly what I needed. But you know who's not going to care, Dina? You know who will judge you not for the stain on your shirt, but for the content of your character? Our next guest this week, we have got Molly-Jaye Kirchner. Our guest is an esthetician, a mother of two Great Danes and a perfect cat. Her cult thriller, The ALVAH, is available now on Amazon. Molly-Jaye Kirchner, welcome to the show, buddy.
Hi. Thank you for having me.
So, Molly, how are you doing today, buddy? Welcome to the show. Are you excited? Nervous? Are you sutilated currently?
That's literally not a word.
Oh my God.
It's a word now. He blatantly said sutilated just to bother you.
Right,
this time.
But
he didn't say it last time.
If he looks at our comments from Fanny on the last episode, it's titillating that he was trying to go for.
No, scintillating is what he was going for. Is a word. Yes, it is. Scintillating is absolutely a word, Dina.
Scintillating, Dina. Sparkling or shining brightly.
I'm definitely that.
I'll take my apology now.
Okay.
Yeah, see? That's Molly is scintillating. Look at her.
I think Molly's radiant, honestly.
Sparkly.
Oh, thank you.
Yes, that's what I was trying to say. I didn't want to put her off balance
sparkly
immediately
like
when
Edward
she came in, but she looked
Twilight.
A little sparkly. Yeah, vampires do sparkle. That's a very good point. That's a very solid point.
Well, I might be
but
a
you
vampire.
You want to know who else sparkles? Yeah, you could be. But you want to know who else sparkles, audience? I just want you to know that we've got the third member of our team, and audience, he wants to kiss you all over and over and again. He wants to kiss you all over till the pod exit song closes in. Till the pod exit song closes in. Producer Sean, everyone. Till the mic closes in. Thank you for dropping that for me. I appreciate it. I can't hit the high notes.
Hi,
like
Molly.
Producer
Welcome
Sean.
To the show.
Hi.
Yeah, so Molly, I heard that you've got a very special little story time for us.
I do. Yeah, it's something.
Wait,
something
wait, wait, Molly, 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 wait,
oh,
wait.
Oh,
whoa, whoa,
sorry,
whoa,
sorry. Whoa. Listen,
Daniel,
I need you to tease
how about
the
you
audience.
Not interrupt her
Give
like
them
that?
A little tickle. Hold on,
what?
We have to tickle. I need the titillating, scintillating tease tickling. Of the audience. Could you do that for me, Molly?
Like, do you want me to get close to the mic? Like, something, something, my porn star name. Is that good? Did I do it?
Ooh.
Yeah, that's perfect. That's a tease.
All right.
That's a tease.
I'm about to be ripped apart for that.
I've done much worse.
Destroyed. Wait, our audience is brutal. It's no hold. Yep. Oh, yeah. It's about to be brutal, Molly.
Just a reminder, Molly.
Wait.
When you hear the buzzer, that means you have to drink. And for the audience, keeping track at home, Our guest Molly is right-handed, so she's using her left hand to drink this evening.
But her right hand is her guide.
Right, don't it's forget. My guide.
Yeah, she gets one finger. She gets the right pointer finger.
It's wine, and I don't want to... It's red, and I don't want to... So I get to do that.
That's fair. We've given her this exception.
There's been some exceptions, but you want to know what there's no exception for, Sean? It's time for our game segment. This is a particular favorite of Dina, which means, obviously, I'm very disappointed, and I apologize, audience, I'm doing something that Dina enjoys, but producer Sean, why don't you, whoa. Hey.
Dab on him.
Dab on him. Producer Sean, why don't you give us a little, tell us what we got coming up.
We're playing the word association game. This is a game where I will provide a random word to one of the three contestants here. They will immediately respond with their gut reaction to that word with another word, and we'll go down the line to all three of you in a chain. And then I'll go to the next person and give them
like
another word.
Like the human centipede.
Oh, no, Dina, no. You've seen Human Centipede, but you haven't seen Happy Gilmore?
I've never what seen humans. Fuck, I've never seen Human Centipede. Okay, I will never watch that.
I don't
the,
want
the
to be
legend
a part
of the
that.
Human centipede precedes itself.
Please don't.
No,
Molly's like, I have to be somewhere. I can't continue right. The show.
You know what? Mom, you know, it's been so nice being here, but I gotta go.
wouldn't be the first time. No. Anyway, so here we go. The word association game. Normally I prepare a list of words, but today I'm using a random word generator. So I'll be surprised right along with you. And Dina, since you are the queen of the word association game, why don't you go first? And then Daniel will go. And then Molly will go. Okay. So you're each reacting to each other's words. Gut reaction. First thing you think of.
I'm here great at this game. This is going to go well.
Dina. Daniel is awful at this game. Your word is cabin.
Patch.
Cabin patch kids? Cabbage patch kids.
Daniel, that's not how you play the game. You just react to my word. You're not making a sentence. You fucking dumbass.
I
think it's like
what 10-word story.
Yeah, no, it's fine. All right, fine. Wait, what was the word? What was the word?
Patch.
Okay. Patch Adams.
It's already too long. Oh, my God.
Patch Adams, it's done. Molly, you're up.
The president. That's all I got.
All right. Good warm-up, everyone except Daniel.
Yeah, excellent.
Daniel, you're starting this one, okay? And then we'll go to Sean, Molly, go and then we'll go to Dina. Here we go. Yes, you can go first, buddy.
Okay.
No, he's doing a quarantine.
I know. He's doing the bit. He's doing the bit. It's just not landing. Okay.
No, don't worry.
Prove.
All right, Sean, can you go first?
it's especially not landing because you're delayed.
I know this delay so sucks. Like, I hate it so much.
We're sitting here like,
I fucking hate the delay. Yeah. Oh my God. Mm-hmm. Do you think if I go out and come back in one more time, it'll help?
That's what she said.
Oh. We could, I mean, as Miriam would probably tell you, we can try, I guess.
Oh. It's true.
346 minutes later.
All right, Daniel's back, everybody.
It's only when we have guests that we have issues. When it's just the three of us, smooth sailing every time.
Every time.
Every single time. Yeah, that's only because no one's there to see it. Okay. Daniel, your word is total.
Total recall.
does he know how to play this game?
It's a movie.
I don't think so.
Oh, wait. I thought, no. But didn't he play it right and I was supposed to go off the recall?
Yeah,
you're supposed to go off of recall, but what he's doing is he's continuing the first word rather than just saying the next word that comes to mind. So
okay, fine.
It's supposed
recall.
To be like total, and then he could say recall.
There you go.
All right, done.
And
all
then
right,
you go off of recall.
Good. Yeah, all right. We got
okay,
this.
But it's my turn, so hang on.
Yes.
Wait.
Yes.
I don't know. Light bulb.
Awesome.
Machine.
Love it.
Terminator.
2.
Okay, Molly, you're first this time.
I was just keeping it going.
Oh, we're just going to keep going around?
Yeah, Dana, your word's 2. Your word's 2.
2, 7.
What?
Okay, Molly, you're starting off with a new word. Okay. It is dilute.
Water.
A sub pump.
Basement.
All right.
Damn it. You're just remembering that all of our friends are flooded right now and are like in significant weather. Yeah, and we're just sitting here like, oh, it's a little rainy right now.
Is it snowing in Ohio?
We are actually having an ice storm tonight. It's good times. We get snow overnight, and then tomorrow is going to be a high of 26. I love it here.
It is.
So, like, when you get an ice storm, like, do you actually have to still try to go into work, or do you just, like, how bad does the weather have to be for Ohio to be like, fuck it?
Well, they level, like, they have these levels for our roads. Like, if it's level 1, you can drive, but, you know, you have to be cautious. If it's level 2, you can't drive on side roads, but you can drive on the highways. I personally tell every one of my clients, I'm like, listen, if I see a snowflake, I'm not coming in. Done. So they know. Like, I tell them right up front. I'm like, oh, you're a new client? Cool. Well, just so you know, the months of January through March, we might never see each other. I don't know. But I don't mess around with that. No, I've been in 14. This sounds really bad. I've been in 14 accidents. And I have a single one. Not a single one. So.
Yeah, you figure after number 14, you're like, you know what? I'm just not going to try to drive in the snow anymore.
Right? I'm done.
14? Holy shit.
Yeah. I had like, I think I like, had have 7 you considered- by high school. So everybody called me a cat. But I surpassed my 9 lives.
Oh. Yeah. I mean,
winner.
At what point do you check to see if, like, you're living on an Indian burial ground or have some sort of curse going on?
No, I think I just accepted that I'm cursed long ago. It's fine. I'm Transylvanian. That's my background. So I'm convinced that somewhere down the line, like, you know, my people were either killed or they were vampires. I don't know.
Is that close to Czechoslovakia? Oh my God.
Yes. Yes. I think it's now Romania.
Okay.
Don't quote me.
Dina's husband is descended from royalty out in the Slavic regions.
In Czechoslovakia.
Oh.
Well, it was right before the war.
Maybe we were old-timey friends.
That's why I was like, hey, maybe vampires together. Families.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Actually, fun fact. Oh, wait. This has to be cut. Our last name actually means prophet of the vampires. So.
What?
Oh my God, maybe?
Yeah.
Maybe related.
We could. Sisters, we got curly hair, right? I mean,
this is
it. Anthony is so triggered right now. Anthony is so triggered right now. If you were watching this, him and Stevie are going to come and hunt both of you down.
They're vampire hunters. Also, for the record, Czechoslovakia split off into Czech Republic and Slovakia in the early 90s.
Okay.
Oh.
Good Look at facts. Us learning stuff. Oh, you didn't think it would be an educational show. Yeah. This is practically Sesame Street. Yeah, this isn't.
That's true. That's exactly.
That's what we sell ourselves as. Is I have a basically puppet. Sesame Street.
Right, exactly.
Okay, what's the next word?
Dina, let's go with rational.
Infection.
Hold on, I got this. Hold on, wait. Can I go first on this? Can you tell me rational again?
See, you've already thought about it, though. That defeats the purpose of the game.
Yeah, but I have to say the joke. I have to do it. I don't care if it's late and too long and whatever.
Sure. Here's your word, Daniel, that you've never heard before. Rational.
What is not Dina?
That's not a word.
Okay, so this isn't Jeopardy.
Oh, sorry. I thought for sure that I had this.
This is the simplest game.
This is not Jeopardy, despite what you may have heard.
the simplest game he can't do.
It really is.
It's the only game this. With one rule that we have.
It really is.
I mean, you're doing a good job, though.
It's fine. Thanks, Molly. I appreciate
solid effort, buddy.
D's get degrees.
I hope she never talks to you
okay.
again.
Okay. Dina, let's try again. Dina, your word is hardware.
Software.
Oh, me. Sorry. Porn.
Twitter.
Oh, hey! We actually made it through one.
How Jesus, to say that I've received far too many unsolicited dick pics without saying I've received far too many unsolicited dick pics.
All right, Daniel. Your word is serve.
Now all I can think about is dick pics. I'm sorry, man. Dick pics.
Twitter.
Spaces.
Oh, all right, Twitter
that checks out. Yeah.
Twitter spaces.
I think fleets is what you were thinking of.
Yeah, fleets is what we were looking for there. Yeah.
All right,
by the way, there was an account I came across today, and like he'd gotten like called out by other people, and literally on his bio he's like, yeah, listen, man, my account's for porn, and if you follow me, you're just gonna see my dick a lot. And I was like, you know what, you're still a piece of shit, but I at least applaud your honesty for like being upfront about what your game is.
Like, that's, you know, respect to that guy.
John Doe's the name, porn's the game.
All right, Molly. Sorry. Your word is accumulation.
No.
Angel.
The Avila.
Dick pics.
Listen, accumulation would have been perfect for dick pics. We could have gone down this road again.
You know what?
But you're not supposed. You're literally supposed to say the first word that comes to your mind when you hear the word that comes out of my mouth.
This is the word that's doing in my mind right now. I can see you deliberately thinking about it. I can see the wheel.
He's trying to be funny.
But no. The Avila worked though. Am I even pronouncing this fucking thing? Am I pronouncing this right, Molly?
What?
The ALVAH.
Why do I keep calling it the Avila?
She had no idea you were trying to say her.
I didn't. I don't. I didn't.
Nagila.
She said I didn't.
I shouldn't be allowed on anything. I shouldn't be here to promote anything. I was trying to say the ALVAH, and I'm back to fucking up names, and I think we should drink for me fucking up a name.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure I did that in the intro and in her. Yeah.
You did. I knew what you were trying to say, but I was like, I don't think it's spelled like that.
You know what? We just, around here, we call that going back to the well. You know, it worked early on in the series run, and we're bringing it back, baby. Right back Daniel can't pronounce anything. Okay, I'm Dina, useless. One more round. Let's do it.
Okay, let's go.
The word is digital.
Oh my God, I don't like what came to my head. So,
We know. Listen, hold on. No, if you want to play the word association game,
I was gonna say sponge. Because I thought you were setting me up. I thought you were setting me up to say sponge because it was the last word, and I was like, "Oh, sponge is gonna be on my head."
You already had.
I am gonna do that at some point, but yeah, I don't want you to see it coming.
That's not the one.
Yeah, we gotta do a new word. She, you know. Yeah.
All right. Love.
Fest.
Hot dog.
You're thinking way too hard,
Daniel.
Buddy.
Hot dog fest. Hot dog fest. It's fine.
He said hot dogs.
Oh, I didn't hear him say hot dogs. Penises.
Hey!
Full circle!
I'll take it. This has been the word association game or something that looks kind of like adjacent. It, but not really.
Hooray! Yeah, it's adjacent. It's fine. It's He's good.
You ruined this game.
Oh, I know. I do it on purpose because I love you, Dina.
I know. And it's very obvious because you sit there and you go, that's you. That's you breathing.
Really?
Into
you're, doing,
the mic.
You're doing my breathing voice? You're doing my breathing voice. So, I already had to hear that enough.
Just seen it.
Quarantine book club?
In post, I am going to make the times you stop to think, I'm going to extend that by about 10 seconds each time. And I'm going to zoom in real close on your face. Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
Just so we're clear.
Just like that? Yeah. We're all about storytelling here, and as such, we try to share a fun story each week. And so without further ado...
It's story time with Molly.
That's a lot of pressure, by the way. All right, so my story is something, something, my porn star name. And we have to do a lot of backstory with this one, okay? So we're going to start in November of 1982, when I was born. In 1982, the ultrasound showed my leg.
Right?
No, I mean 82. I wish. but my leg, they thought was a dingle. It wasn't. It was just a leg. But I was supposed to be a boy, and my name was supposed to be Jay, J-A-Y. And when I came out, the doctor, no joke, the doctor.
I'm glad that it clicked in my head that you're in the womb.
Yes, I'm in the womb.
And not like.
Yeah.
Not like.
After she was born,
that would have been the worst doctor ever.
The ultrasound was a third leg. Not literally out of my mother. No, but when I did come out of my mom.
All right.
The doctor, no joke, he told her my pecker fell off. And so my mom scrambled then to think of a name for me. And my mom's name is Molly. So she was like, well, her name will be Molly too. But this is a woman who just had a baby. And now they're calling her Big Molly and me Little Molly. And I don't know. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's universal that if you call a woman big anything, she is going to be offended. So I became...
Yeah, that's
right. That's
terrible
big
idea.
No-no. So I became Molly J. Yeah. As a first name. It's M-O-L-L-Y hyphen J-A-Y-E. They added the E, I guess, to sound feminine. So then came time for my middle name.
Very feminine.
Right. Molly J. So then came time for my middle name, and my mom was like, well, I'll give her my maiden name, which is McKittrick. And I didn't even know how to spell that word. Like, you can't give a little kid, like, a little C and a big K.
I don't.
It's impossible.
Hold on 1 second, Dina. Quickly spell it. Give us what can, give us what you got. McKittrick.
M-I-K-T-R-I-C-H.
No.
No. No.
Do you want me to spell
it? What did that even spell?
C-K?
Yes, please.
Yeah, go
it's
ahead.
M-C capital K-I-T-R-I-C-K. So McKittrick.
Okay.
And then my last name is Kirchner. So that is my legal name, Molly-Jaye McKittrick Kirchner. Okay. And Little Molly grows up and wants to be a writer, right? And so I was like, oh, well, I'll pick a pen name. And so what I did for my pen name was I just became Jay McKittrick. Like, I took it out of the middle because I was like, well, I have 57 names to choose from, so I'll just be Jay McKittrick. And so I wrote two fiction novels under that name and one, like, memoir with vignettes, but you can't get any of them. I took them all down. So, sorry. But then I wrote a children's series.
We love those.
Oh, we'll
you
find
can find them.
We'll
you
find
can't
them.
Buy
we'll
them.
Find them.
No, so I wrote this children's book series under the Jay McKittrick
name. Bold of you to assume we buy.
No, so, okay, so here's the books, right? The Messy World of Little Miss Molly. It was about me, obviously. It's got, like, the curly hair and stuff. And so this Aww. Is, my husband and I did this for our honeymoon. We didn't go away. We made these books. And hang on, I'm losing my earpiece here. So I didn't mark, like, this was pre big Twitter marketing that we know of now. So I used to do readings at the schools, and it's a pre-K through, like, max second grade book. Okay. So I did a lot of those classes, and I'm really awkward with kids. So that was not an easy task for me, but my friend who's a teacher asked me if I would do a reading for her sixth grade class. They were doing a program called Young Authors. I don't know if you guys are familiar with that at all, but you basically, like, make your own book.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So she wanted me to come in and like talk to this sixth grade class. And when you do readings in a classroom, like the teachers are gone. They're like, bye, like peace. I'm going to go talk shit about little Timmy in the back.
That's their
smoke right, exactly. Break. So they just leave me up there and I'm talking to the kids, and this little kid, he raises his hand and I'm like, you know, yeah, what do you want to know? And he's like, what's your porn star name? And I'm sitting there like jaw on floor. Like, I don't know what to say because A, I don't have kids, so I don't really know like how to properly talk to them. But like, I'm an adult and he's like a 12-year-old boy, right? And he's asking me this question and I'm just like, and then I start to think about it. I'm like, should I tell him like a porn star name? And I'm like, no, that's not appropriate at all, you creep. So I do not come up with a name. I'm just sitting there like with my, you know, jaw on the floor. And finally the teacher in the back room, she's like, do you mean her pen name? And I'm like, how in the hell was I supposed to get that? Like, good kudos on that lady for figuring that out. Cause I don't know. Maybe I'm just not smart enough to get it. But that is the story of the porn star.
Yeah, that's never an answer.
Right?
That's beautiful. But by the way, if you want to, the traditional way to come up with your porn star name is you go middle name and the name of the street you grew up on.
So McKittrick 10th?
My name would be Joseph Continentals.
Yeah. See, that's a good one, though. Mine sucks.
Yours is a little less hot.
Joseph Continentals.
I want a new one.
I'm just saying.
Oh, Dina. Dina doesn't want to tell us her real name.
If it gets cut, I'll tell you.
Tell us.
Yes, it can be cut. Yep.
It would be Lee Autumn.
Oh, that's pretty.
Yeah, that's a porn star name.
You might actually be doing some lesbian porn with that name.
Yeah, that's a porn star name.
Mm-hmm. 100%. Thomas Lago. Yep.
Why, you guys all got good ones.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I quit.
I told you that's a porn star thing.
That's crazy.
Yeah, I'm sorry,
yeah,
Molly.
That was pretty mortifying. That's
like
the last school reading I did.
You'd be like a futuristic porn star. It's like just a cyborg.
she's a robot porn star.
All right.
McKittrick 10th. Yeah.
Once again, Anthony's interested.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
God.
Oh, man. All right. So, Molly, now that we're suitably porn starified, because there's no good answer to when a child asks you awkward questions.
Situated.
I'm
very situated over
situated.
Here.
Hey, everybody, this is Joseph Continentals giving you a really
situated
experience.
You guys should change your name for this particular show to all of your porn star names.
Yeah. I'm in. I'm down.
Saurus Autumn.
Yeah, they're okay. All right.
Saurus Autumn.
Saurus Autumn.
Saurus Autumn. My pen name.
Oh, man. So, Molly, do you have some tissues nearby? Perhaps a fine neckerchief or... You do? Okay, good.
I do.
Good.
Are you
oh, my God, you do.
Cry?
You are the first one that's actually got something.
I'm not messing around.
So
listen.
The first one, Daniel, but that's okay.
Listen, before we hit record, Molly said she was treating this like she was going on Oprah, so she's prepared to cry is what she's saying.
I'm ready for my cry moment.
And I'm prepared to jump up and down on my couch. Yeah. Dina doesn't get that reference
Dina,
either.
You don't
you're
get
too
that
young,
one?
Dina. You're
Tom Cruise?
I was judging
him. All right.
I was just judging him. I was just going to yell at him.
Oh, that's fine. Yeah, no,
and
no,
I was
going
to say something about your mom's couch and your mom's basement. But I was like, no, don't be rude, Dina.
Bless.
Okay, buddy.
This is where we get personal, Molly. And we're going to peel back the layers of the potato. And Dina's going to ask some hard-hitting, insightful, emotional questions. And I hope you're mentally and emotionally prepared.
I'm ready.
First question. What is the weirdest question you've ever been asked?
One, right here, right now.
I hope she brings
this one. I think we know the answer.
No, yeah, you do know the answer.
No, Molly, bring it
you,
back.
You do know the answer. It's you know, what's your porn star name? There it is.
There you go. I thought that was pretty fitting. It's a good warm-up.
Nailed it.
It is good.
It's a softball. Yeah. Okay. What is your biggest pet peeve, literary or personal?
Like, wait, are you asking me literary or personal? Which one of those is my pet peeve?
Like up to
either
you.
One.
Okay, no, those. Yeah, do both. No, both.
You
let's
know
get
personal.
Both.
Like,
let's get both
pet peeve.
In there.
Yeah. Yeah. My pet peeve. I don't know. I hate feet. I'm not supposed to say that. Wait, I'm not supposed to say it.
Ah, we hate it too. But yeah, no, yeah.
Oh, we're, shit.
And we hate it too, though. Fell. So that's fair.
Yeah, no. I wanted to go into nail tech work, and I couldn't do pedicures because I don't want to touch your nasty, like, summer feet. Ugh, that's so gross. I'm sorry.
Oh. Oh my God! No, I'm with you. I agree. Yeah.
Do you like pickles?
No.
Mm-mm. Oh my God! Blessed be.
Oh no! Not even jerkins.
No pickles. Actually, I have the palate of a 5-year-old child. I like chicken nuggets. And
hey, you know what? Bless. We have a friend Bless. That is the goddess of stink pickles named Shannon that
lives by chicken nuggies.
Chicken nuggies, be praised.
Yeah, yeah, give me blessed. All the bad foods. No, I don't eat salads. So, I mean, where, I'm not a rabbit.
Where are you going for the
bad food? Not a rabbit.
I love it.
I do. I poop quite
Did
well.
Did you say,
you.
Do you poop at all?
She doesn't eat salads. How
I don't eat salads.
How's she supposed to get nutrients?
I mean, I didn't
understand. That wasn't a question. I
bowel
like, oh, for
cycles
show.
Work without salad, right? Like, these are not related functions.
I'm just assuming that if you don't eat salad, you're not eating other vegetables too.
No,
but you're still
I
consuming
eat other vegetables.
Things and vegetables. Okay, but hold on. Even if she didn't eat vegetables. Didn't eat any vegetables at all. Oof. She would still poop if she consumed any sort of sustenance.
Anything. Yeah.
Okay, but it's good. She's going to be a little bit complicated.
Yeah, next, Molly, we're going to ask you about the consistency of
okay.
your poops.
All right. You guys want to know color?
No, but I'm so worried about
sizes.
Why Dina thinks you
Do you
Let
have
me
any
pull
photos?
Up the chart from the hospitals.
No, hold on. I'm still yeah, worried that Dina thinks you need to eat vegetables in order to poop, and I'm very concerned about this.
You need fiber.
You do need fiber.
I mean,
yes, but still.
Well, I get fiber in other ways. I get my fiber. I just don't eat salad.
Okay, but this
Listen,
but this does
we're not
actually
your doctor.
Pose.
We're not going to judge you for your diet, Molly. You don't does have to tell us about how regularly you poop. It's okay.
But okay, hold on. I do have a very important poop-related question, though.
Okay.
If a vampire consists solely on a liquid blood diet, what do you think their poops are like? Like, what do you think a vampire poop?
Explosive bloody. Diarrhea.
Guano.
Yeah.
Bloody guano.
Yeah. I mean,
it's a straight liquid.
That's self-explanatory. Yeah. You know, you're ingesting the blood.
Just pee it?
And you're pooping the blood.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So it's just going straight through.
Yeah, like
that's a good question.
The learning doesn't stop here on Sesame Street.
Oh, they could, but well, I think doesn't the body like you have to pee and poop though? So maybe it would separate
yeah,
like, certain
you
toxins
can't.
To the urine and then certain toxins to the butthole. This is very scientific. I was not ready for
this
all
this
science.
Is, yeah,
listen.
Yeah, we
for the
we're
folks
an educational
at home,
podcast.
This is not medical advice. This is not. There's no basis in real truth or facts in any of what
oh
we're saying
God.
Right now. Please do not take us seriously. Consult your doctor about your diet and your pooping schedule.
Dina could have been a doctor.
And if you're a vampire, please.
Disappoint her grandma instead.
and for any God. Vampires listening out here, please shoot us a message and let us know what your fecal matter is like. We would love to know.
Please don't do that.
You can call us on our voicemail. It. Okay, what is the best or worst thing you have ever purchased?
Oh, I got a shake weight because I'm an idiot. And I just looked like I was jerking
yes!
off. I did,
yeah, just,
I did.
Yes. Don't let anyone see you using it, that's all.
No.
Do you
Dumbest
still have
thing
it?
I've ever
do you
bought.
Still have it?
I do.
Molly, do you still have Can you please
no,
get it?
Do you want
no,
me to get it?
Just no.
Please.
No.
Yes, I really do.
Don't make
yes,
a jerk off
yes.
the shake weight. Stop.
Listen,
no.
I get so much harassment on these.
Off. I just want to see it. Send me a shake weight pic, baby. Just shoot in my DMs.
Okay, I'll send you.
Oh my God.
I will be harassed so much worse on Twitter if I bust out that shake weight. But I will send you a picture, and that will be
you can my DMs see and send me 100%. Yep.
I'm censoring. I'm not asking you made the motion. I'm censoring that.
Yeah, you did. Please do.
That's getting blurred. We don't need any GIFs.
John West is going to finally tune back in and just make it shake weight.
Call Coralie and tell her to walk downstairs and just bitch slap her son, please.
Just
thank you.
Unplug the computer.
To be very clear, I'm not asking you to use the shake weight. Listen, I just want to see it.
This isn't sexual at all, okay? He just has an exercise equipment fetish, that's all.
I wouldn't be here if Daniel was ever going to sexually harass a woman. I would.
Oh my goodness, no. I don't think he's... listen, no. You're fine. But,
Sean is the only person I sexually harass.
That's true. Are you guys ready? Are you ready?
Yeah. Is it time?
What is... It's time. It's time.
It's time for...
What is the big question? The superior form of potato?
Oh, shit.
And before you answer, Molly, that's a great answer.
All of them is an acceptable answer.
Oh, it is? Okay, good.
Fuck no. We haven't had that.
No.
But here's what I need.
I
need you to come in hot.
We're looking for a very, very aggressive take.
An aggressive take on my favorite potato.
Allow
this
no disagreement.
Form of potato.
Yeah. Do not let any argument
throw the hammer
exist.
Down.
All right, mashed.
There's no pan potato-ness.
Mashed.
Mashed.
Mashed. Right. Mashed. Let's go. Tell us why.
Because on Thanksgiving, I have a contest with my cousins to see who can eat the most, and it's me. So...
Mashed potato champion.
Tradition.
Let's go.
I want this tradition.
Okay, that should have been my story.
You leave a little bit of skin.
Yeah, a little. I do like a little bit of skin in there. Yes.
Oh yeah.
Okay, good.
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
Good. And I can take or leave gravy. I can take it or leave it. Oh.
Same.
That's fair.
That's fair. Yeah.
For me at Thanksgiving, I also good compete enough. About who can eat the most mashed potatoes, but it's just with myself, and there's no winner or loser.
Personal record.
There is a loser because I hate myself afterwards. But
no, this Thanksgiving I'm going to get you on film. We'll do the contest together. We'll do a little Zoom call.
It's a date.
That's amazing. Yes,
sold.
We're going to do it.
Sold. I'm in. Oh my god, I've never wanted to have a mashed potato eating contest more. I'm so excited.
Well, have a good time.
I won't eat for the whole day before this. I'm ready.
No, and you don't eat stuffing. Yeah. Like, stay away from the stuffing.
No.
I mean, it's called stuffing, right?
You can't
fill yourself with something else.
Exactly.
I mean, let's be honest. My family's going to forget that I can't have onions, and they'll put onions in the stuffing anyway, like they do every year. So.
Assholes.
I'm going to send you some stuffing, and we're going to have a potato eating contest.
Now hold on, I'm going to take this full circle. I'm going to take this full circle here. Because did you know, and I found this out because I know useless knowledge. The best way if you're going to eat competitively to in order, you don't not eat because that makes your stomach shrivel up and get tight. So you can't fit as much.
Yeah.
You eat lettuce in that morning because it doesn't sit, it doesn't take up room,
Molly,
but it expands your stomach.
Nope. It'll make you poop.
It'll make you poop.
Nope. Not gonna do it.
Will you even have like a Caesar salad or like
nothing? Listen, she said she's not a rabbit, okay?
And no, I you know what I think? It's like a texture thing, because I also don't like coconut. And if you think about like the texture of coconut and lettuce, it's really similar. And I think like for me it's more of a texture because lettuce doesn't really taste like anything.
Yeah, it really doesn't taste like much.
Maybe like a romaine does, but not like regular, like a, you know,
it's
the lettuce that you'd have in a
97% water
salad. Right. Yeah. But I can't have it. No.
Mm-mm. Oh, man.
What about a Greek salad where they have mashed potatoes in it?
I've never tried a Greek salad.
Isn't that like a hot potato salad?
Maybe. If you guys ever have me back,
what about just a taco salad?
Greek salad.
A taco salad is like
eating with Molly.
All the fixings
eating,
of a taco
oh my
in a
God,
bowl
yes,
with
eating
like
with Molly.
A couple of shreds of lettuce on top.
No, I don't even like.
We're gonna do this. We're gonna bring it back.
Tacos.
Eating with Molly.
Yes.
Oh.
And I'll eat.
All right.
I guess a salad. Oh God, what have I done?
Oh no. What? We'll put, Molly, you we'll can't come back from
mashed
this.
Mashed potatoes in that salad. Okay. It'll be okay.
All right.
Sean all just right. caught a fly with his bare hands. Did anybody
bullshit. Did you
that?
Really?
What?
Did you really?
I did.
He did.
What
he did.
The fuck?
He's a Karate Kid?
Like, I watched the whole thing.
It wasn't chopsticks.
I need, okay.
Yeah, I caught it.
When we replay this, when this goes live, I need this to be zoomed in. I need all other cameras off. I need a full focus on Sean fucking ninjing a fly.
Incredible.
Holy shit.
I just watched this man go, and then I watched him watch it go. Like, what?
Okay. I wish I had seen this. Okay.
Sean is nonchalant really about now. His badassery. Holy fuck. Yeah. Well, don't worry. On the reset of this, you'll be good. But okay. All right, Molly, it is time. It's time for you. We're going to get to your book, which is The ALVAH, the Avila, because I'm not a fucking idiot anymore, which is available on Amazon. And it is an incredible book. And I cannot wait to discuss this with you. But before we actually get into your book, Molly, how dare you?
What? What did I do?
How dare you? We got
already.
Like 10 pages in. And you were trying to cancel straws. How dare you?
You know what, though? I'm such a liar because I use straws every day with everything.
Is that a plastic straw?
It is. It is. I'm a phony.
Son of a bitch.
Your aunt.
Oh, no. I did.
Oh, she got buffaloed on the straw.
I did. I knew I did it.
Okay, so just take like an extra big gulp.
Yeah, okay? Big gulp. Big gulp. Wait, like you're back in college.
That's a lot of wine.
That's a lot of wine.
It's wine, people. We can't make her check that.
Oh, did that get up the nose?
Yeah.
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 All right. Perfect. So, all right. But seriously, something that really stuck out to the book, once I started reading it and we started going into it, this was an ambitious effort of you. Because if you talk about, we talk about genre blending all the time on our show. And we had crime thriller. We had occult. We had some fantasy. We had some sci-fi and a little steamy romance in there as well. What made you want to take on just a giant genre mashup of a novel?
Because I'm a fucking idiot. It's a plain and simple answer. No, you Wait, know, I had this idea in my head. Well, I thank you. No, I had the worst time when I was pitching as to what the hell genre it actually was. I was like, is it this? Is it that? Because I did pull so many different elements and I was watching a lot of Ancient Aliens at the time. And
like in real life or like, is this a movie?
No,
or something?
Like I was watching a lot of Ancient Aliens and I was also simultaneously, I always watch. No, I always watch killer documentaries. They're like my favorite. They like put me to sleep. So I was like, well, I know cop stuff and I know alien stuff and I'm really obsessed with the religion. I don't know why. I just like it. So I studied a lot of it in college. So I was like, you know, I'm just going to throw this all together and see what happens. And that was the birthing of the ALVAH.
And listen, and that was the thing, like the further I got in, I was like, all right, maybe they're just metaphorically talking about Mars. And they're like, no, they're colonizing it right now. I was like, holy shit, everything's going on. It's awesome. Talk me through how your character creation here with Rachel and with Noah, because Rachel is one of those rare types that, especially in the beginning, she's kind of got a little bit of that hard boiled detective feel to her. She smokes a lot. She drinks a lot. She has no fucks to give. Like, she's a really fascinating character.
Thank you. Rachel is like me on a bad day, but she just smokes and drinks too much. I really love a strong female lead. It bothers me a lot when I read that lovey-dovey, perfect, like faux fairy. I don't know. Like if I want a cop, I want her to be tough. Like she's going to be like a person who doesn't put up with shit. She's not going to be somebody who's like, oh, but I love him. You know what I mean? And so I wanted her to have like balls. And it was really important to me, I think, for her backstory to be very kind of traumatic and very questionable. Like, I left her backstory kind of up to the interpretation of the reader as to where they wanted to take things. Because I never explicitly say one way or the other how her childhood actually went. I just give you these little drops.
Yeah. No, I'm with you on that.
So let's talk about spinning in like the religious aspects and like the theology throughout the story too.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what was that like?
So I grew up, I'm Lutheran. I don't know if you guys are familiar with that. It's basically like
Martin Luther
pulled OG from the, right. He pulled from the Catholic Church and started the Protestant Reformation. Right. So like, we don't do saints. We don't do, confessionals. It's just as angry and mean though. Like, I want to make that very clear.
There is just for my own, cause I like to learn about religions and stuff. Lutheran still does infant baptism, right?
Yes. Yes. And we do.
Yeah, okay. I just wanted to make sure I was on the right path.
Yeah. And we do, it's called, we go through what's called catechism class. And that's when we're like 12, 13, and then we get confirmed and then we're allowed to take communion. So I grew up in this church, and when I had gone through catechism class, my pastor said that my cousin could not get into heaven because he was gay. And he also told me that I would not get wings when I went to heaven, and I'm very afraid of heights. And I was like, you know what? I don't like this. And right? So I didn't leave the church.
I mean, at least you still got into heaven. You just can't fly around.
Yeah. You can't fly around. You're going to fall.
Wait, I have a question. Mm-hmm. So are Lutherans taught that when they go to heaven, they become angels?
No, but I thought I would. And then I was told I wouldn't.
Oh, okay. I was like, I
haven't. Sorry. Okay. Well, and the whole gay thing too, like, that is not some like thing that Lutherans believe. I think it was just a very old school minister who was putting that old school view on us. But you know, I was a kid, so I was very like, that bothered me a lot. I'm like, my cousin has to get into heaven. So, I didn't leave the church, but I just left organized religion. And then I got into like mythologies, and I started to study a lot of different things. And so I just kind of made up my own, I guess, thing that I believe in. Like, I believe in God. I think if you're a good person, you'll go to heaven. I think if you're a shithead, you go somewhere else. And that's how I live my life, you know? And so bringing in that aspect of religion, it's like, I just tried to study the more Catholic thoughts because I wasn't really familiar with all of them. And I had to have these priests involved. And so that was challenging. But I also didn't want to center on the religious aspect either, because I didn't want it to become that book either. You know, I didn't want people to be like, oh, it's the priests and they, you know, what are they doing to the children? I didn't want to go there. But I wanted them to be bad. I knew that. Does that answer your question?
No, and I think that there was...
I was just trying to get you to talk about it. That's all,
So, I mean, in general, one of the things that we always like to talk about is some of the romance tropes and some of the things that happen in these types of stories. And one of our favorite points of discussion is love triangles. And you've got a pretty potent love triangle, maybe sometimes even rectangle going on here. How did you go about creating that and navigating the pathways of it?
I thought a lot about Keanu Reeves.
Go on.
Yes. So here's the deal. Okay. As writers, we always put ourselves in the story, right? So I was like, well, if I'm represented by this mean, ballsy detective, then who would I want to bang? Keanu Reeves. Fact. Done. Sold.
Nice.
Fair.
Right. Whoa. So is who the Charlie character is.
Which era of Keanu? Point Break. Are we talking Bill and Ted? Point Break. Keanu.
Well, I will tell you, I started loving Keanu when he was in parenthood, which is pre-Bill and Ted.
Yeah.
And then he did, do you guys remember the Paula Abdul video? Rush, Rush?
Oh, of course.
Oh my God, we were getting married.
Dina has no idea who Paula Abdul is.
Dina, you need to go watch Paula Abdul, Rush, Rush.
I'm looking it up. You guys keep forgetting that I have a shitty memory.
Well, no, that was very old.
No.
She
also grew up in a cult where she wasn't allowed to listen to music, so this is all way past.
I need you to fuck off, Dina. I'll turn
off. Hey guys, Dina grew up in a cult. I just wanted to let you guys know that.
In case anybody was wondering.
Just let you guys know.
Yeah. Oh my goodness.
This is an occult episode, Daniel.
So, okay, so you got to bang Keanu Reeves, and then who is our other character? Who's Charlie based on?
Well, no, that's Charlie. Charlie's Keanu Reeves.
Oh, Charlie was Keanu Reeves.
Duh.
Yeah.
I always see Keanu Reeves as like a, you know, he does action and okay, all right. Then
he's a sexy Martian-loving cult leader. You gotta love that. Okay.
As most cult leaders are.
So yeah. Noah, and I know this sounds so bad, but Noah is based on my husband. Oh, I know. I know.
So this is how you got your cake and eating it too. Okay, all right.
Yeah. I got to have an affair. We always talked about like the hall pass, you know, and my hall pass is Keanu Reeves and his is Natalie Portman.
Yeah.
It's fair. And I'd be fine with him screwing Natalie Portman.
Same.
So about Keanu Reeves, like what is it that does it for you? I mean,
he's so handsome and he's so sweet and kind. Like he's a good person. And
his heart.
Yeah, like you don't find that in very attractive Hollywood men. So I don't know. I just always loved him.
Included. I mean, it checks out.
Yeah, like I don't know.
They're for me.
Tom Hanks and Keanu Reeves, the most wholesome devil's three-way.
Oh my God.
You would just hear Woody the cowboy the whole time and it just wouldn't, you know, I just feel like that would be a mood ruiner. Fun fact, Natalie Portman is also Daniel's hall pass.
There's a snake in my boot.
If you ever meet her, call
her. There's a snake in my pants. Oh God!
Okay,
this is fun.
It brings a whole new meaning to you. You've got a friend in me.
Got a friend in me.
I've got a friend in me.
Dun, dun. All right.
I've never heard my book read by anybody, so this is actually super exciting.
All right, so here we go. So a nice reading from the ALVAH. So. Noah looked down, considering his options. If he romanticizes the truth to help her heal, it would only give her false hope of an eventual rekindling. He would extinguish any faith in any future by telling her the truth, but it would make it worse. Swallowing, he raised his eyes to her. I did, and it wasn't right, and I'm sorry. A crack resonated in the air as Margaret's hand met the side of his face, hard under the dim street light. Enjoy! Your whore awaits. She turned and jumped into the car. She started the engine and drove off, tires peeling down the road. Kill her. Rachel smirked at the thought. She watched Margaret reach the stop sign. Her hand lifted towards the screen, never removing her eyes from the car. She spread the fingers open, watching the vehicle jerk as Margaret attempted to go. A loud explosion, a ball of light, a deafening blast, glass shattered on the pavement, and metal clanged to the ground. Margaret's car smothered in fire. Noah turned to the scene and then back to Rachel. Call 911, he yelled. He ran to the corner where flames engulfed the vehicle. Rachel looked down at her hand. Her fingers shook. Her eyes enlarged. The memory of a little girl laughing in bed when she made her door shut.
That was very well read.
I'm terrified.
Good job, buddy.
Thank you for reading that. That was nice. I've actually gotten a lot of DMs and like messages about scene.
It's a great scene, man.
No,
like that was the first time that I was like, holy shit, things are getting real, man. Oh my goodness.
No, just people like shocked that I would just like, it was so Like everything was nice and slow, and then all of a sudden it's like boom, it's just kind of came out of nowhere. So I got people like in shock, like, you killed Margaret. It's like, yeah, well, she was a bitch. Like, I don't know.
That's fair.
She was like, Noah's like, you know, take off your shoe because your ankle hurts. And she's like, no. So I don't know. I didn't like her. She had to go.
She was also one trying to cancel straws.
Right.
To be fair.
Yeah.
Let's address the sexual tension in the first quarter, over a quarter of the book. What the fuck?
You might as well just have titled that first part just, can someone kiss someone? God damn it.
No.
The amount of messages that I got from Daniel, like, Dana, the sexual tension in this book. Like, that's all that I got for at least 2 days.
There was a lot.
I am obsessed with the slow burn because I want to make the reader hurt just a little bit. So I'm going to...
They should
right?
Suffer.
Like, you should... It's a cult horror thriller. We don't know what the hell it is, but it's like, I want you to feel the pain of my characters. Like, will they, won't they? I don't know. And now you got this other guy, Keanu Reeves. He shows up and he's like throwing it out there. He's not messing around. He's like, I want to do you. And she's like, you know what? I like that attitude. And it's like Noah had plenty of opportunity to come at her and he plays too nice until that scene right before Margaret happens. It's like, finally, you know, he looks at her and he's like, you know, put the damn wine down. Like, it's time to get down. And that's what they do. Right.
It's like 10 years, man.
Yeah.
So do you think that maybe the sexual tension from the first half of that book is going to lead you into focusing more on romance writing?
Yeah. I don't want to say that I've left this genre. Like, I mean, you guys read the book, so you know that there is opportunity to continue. I've had a lot of people ask me, are you going to do an Elva 2? It's not out of the cards for me, but so when COVID hit, my business closed for 2 months. And it was like the scariest time in my entire life because I didn't know if I was ever going to work again. And I really needed something happy. Like, I needed a pick me up. And I've always used my writing as a therapy. So I was like, you know, I'm going to write a story that's just happy. Now, I like tough characters. So I will never write like I just won't write like your Cinderella. She's not going to be like looking for the guy to give her shoes. She's going to be like, bitch, I have shoes. And so my characters, you know, my females are always going to be tough girls because I'm a tough girl. And I think we need more of that in romance. You see a lot of girls who are like passive and it's like, but I don't think a lot of real women are like that. So I am focusing on romance. Right now, I've written 2 romantic comedies. I can't really talk about them. They're secret. But they are out in the world right now. And I need all the good vibes so that maybe they will be real and you can all read them. Yes, manifest, right? Woo! But yeah, I moved to romance, and I really like romance. I really do. It's fun. I say off the wall things still. I don't know. It's just feel good because you know there's a happy ending. But there are times where it's like, damn, I really miss like writing evil things.
I just want you to get like 3/4 of the way through a romance book and then just have like the twist at the end be like Rachel kicks down a door and just starts slaughtering everyone. And it's like, psych, this is the Alva 2.
Right. It's the Alva you didn't see coming. There it is. Oh, you could do That's What She Said for that one. Did I just do it to myself?
Oh, shit.
That's What She Said?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, I'll drink to that.
That's all right. Yep. Dina does it all the time.
All right. So one last question, because I'd be remiss if I got... If I got too far off of this, because as much as I'd like to discuss a lot of the theology and the female empowerment in this, I feel like it would get us too deep into spoilers. So one of the things that, you know, we always love to discuss is the writer's journey on this show. And for this novel, you were agented, you got published. Kind of talk us through what that process was like for you and getting this thing, you know, I don't want to call it legit, but getting the dream of a lot of us authors out here on Twitter of getting that agent and getting a published book.
Well, this is an indie published book. It's through Darkstroke. They are located in France, and they are just really, they're really nice people. I really like working with them a lot. And we have a nice group of authors and we meet regularly. But I got a hold of them through a pitch contest on Twitter. I want to tell you, it was Pit Dark, because I knew that the novel was dark. I knew, you know, if I had to have one thing that I knew about it, it was dark. So, yeah, and they did not hesitate. They were very quick to, like, be like, we really like where this, you know, novel is. We like where it can go. We love the character. And, I mean, it was a risk to take on that novel just because of the genre. And we agreed, I guess, that it would be like thriller, occult, and horror all kind of combined, because, and I was not on, I was like, horror, really? But, you know, they kind of told me, they were like, anything that scares somebody can be a horror novel. And there are things in that book that are scary. Yeah, they're just a really nice group of people. It's a husband and wife who run it. They work one-on-one with you, like the whole process. It's like, what do you want for your cover? And I knew I wanted a cover that was creepy. I'm going to take this opportunity right now to show you a face of mine. Okay. And there's a reason I'm doing this. I'm going to, my tongue is purple now because I've been drinking wine, but all right. Are you ready? See it? Do you see it? I'm not the fucking cover. Okay. Yeah. It's not me. I've been asked 1,000 times. Yes, the girl has like auburn, wavy, curly hair. This is light brown, people. Okay. And I don't have like that. Just, it's not me. I just want to make that clear.
No, I
think it's because you have similar face shapes.
I saw it on the title page. It says it says it's Adobe stock photography.
Yes, it's not me.
I believe you.
Thank you. I'm glad we covered that base. I've always wanted to do that.
All right. Fair enough. All right, so we're going to get to the off-the-wall questions, and Dina's definitely prepared and ready for it this time, right, Dina?
No, Daniel, I think you're going to go first.
I would like to do that, Dina, but tradition says...
Okay, fine. Charles is replaced by The Rock. How does that change you?
Oh!
Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
I imagine the penetration not is probably rock. A little bigger. Sorry, Keanu. And you know what? I'm going to say no, it doesn't change it that much, because The Rock is pretty good looking. I would accept The Rock as Charles.
The Rock can get it.
Yeah, get that. For real.
All right, that's fair. Okay,
Sorry. Just thinking about it. All right. So Molly, Daniel, normally I ask a question, but here's, sorry, but I'm going to give you a very special opportunity. I want you to look right into this mic, or not right in the mic, right in your camera.
Okay. I'm ready.
No, I want you to make,
don't do it.
Yep. Mm-hmm. I want you to make your pitch to Keanu Reeves about why he should be your hall pass. Give him a love note right now.
Hello, Keanu Reeves.
Oh my God.
I have loved you since I was like 8 or 9. And I'm pretty sure we would make babies that were beautiful, but I can't make babies. So we could just keep trying a lot. And I'd really like to do that with you. You seem like a very nice man. Did I do it? Did I cover it?
Yeah, perfect. I mean, that is excellent.
If I don't get the phone call now, I'm going to be offended.
Making babies with him, yeah.
Our people will contact his people.
I couldn't turn it up, personally.
You couldn't turn. Yeah. You mean turn it down?
What did I? Yep, that's what I meant.
Take it up or turn it down.
I couldn't. Yeah, turn it down.
She can't say no.
She can't.
She can't say no. Yeah.
Like, I want it to be consensual. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to rape Keanu Reeves.
Yeah, no.
I love
him.
Yeah, of course not. That's why you start with, I've loved you since I was eight.
I have.
But I'm older now.
Yeah, I'm going to be 40. So we're good. I'm like, I'm age appropriate.
It's
it's good.
Right. Yeah. I mean, he's way older now.
Totally, in the wheelhouse. Yeah.
Yeah. I think he's like 50. That's true.
He's immortal. So.
Yeah.
He's like late 50s. Yeah.
But he's still 57.
He's nailed it.
Just as freaking handsome. Yeah.
I'm calling shenanigans on him being 57 because I've seen photos of like paintings from like centuries ago that look like Keanu Reeves. So.
He was in Dracula.
I'm pretty sure he's immortal, but that's true.
That's why he's so kind. It could be.
That's right.
He's had
hundreds of thousands of years to prepare.
Yeah, he knows what's up. He's been through some shit. I like that. I like little jazzy tune.
Molly, I hope you're prepared.
I'm ready.
Oh, don't worry. You're going to be hearing a lot of it. Because
we like to celebrate some of the worst erotic literature in history, usually selected by the Literary Review, a British literary magazine, in a segment that we like to call Cringey Copulation. These are real excerpts from real books, and today we indulge in Ian McEwan and crowd favorite American icon Henry Miller. Ian was a English novelist and screenwriter. In 2008, The Times featured him on its list of the 50 greatest British writers since 1945. He has also been ranked as high as number 19 on the list of the 100 most influential, powerful people in British culture.
Powerful.
Henry Miller, on the other hand, has had a lot of books banned. So, don't read ahead, Molly.
I'm not.
Check
I'm just
those
preparing.
DMs, baby.
All right. Wait, I can check it. I see it.
Don't read ahead.
Don't read ahead. Get sensual.
Okay. Wait, I have to get my sensual voice
right
on?
Don't
change. Okay. Yep. I'll get close. Yeah. Okay.
Yep. Get sensual voice on.
Had she pulled on the wrong thing? Had she gripped too tight? He gave out a wail, a complicated series of agonized rising vowels. The sort of sound she had heard once in a comedy film when a waiter, weaving this way and that, appeared to be about to drop a pile of towering soup plates. And there it is. You know what? I'm not going to lie to you. I might have to take a break right now because that was very... What's the word? Scintillating? Is that what we said?
Scintillating.
Scintillating is what it said.
I just like the visual of it, just like the slapsticky, like whoa.
That's not it though, is it, Daniel?
Oh yeah, we got another one. We got two for you here,
what?
Molly. And I'm very excited for you to read this next one.
I don't feel like I signed up for two. Yeah.
You didn't think it'd be that easy? Yeah, well,
I did. I was like,
Kiana
that's
and Tom Hanks, kid.
The first one was a softball.
Oh, God. Okay. Then a groan, a spasm, a wild, tortured look as her face were under a mirror, pounded by a hammer. Don't take it out yet, she grunted. She lay there, her legs still slung around my neck, and the little flag inside her, that's what it said, began twitching and fluttering. God, she said, I can't stop it. My prick was still firm. It hung obedient on her wet lips. Wait, wasn't it just inside her? As though receiving the sacrament from, I can't read that word, the something angel. She came again, like an accordion collapsing in a bag of milk. What the fuck? That's all I'm going to say.
An accordion collapsing in a bag of milk.
Wait. Like a
perfect reaction.
He didn't mean inside her. He meant in her mouth.
I don't know. It says the little flag.
The brand of lips is ambiguous.
In my life, have I heard a woman beg, "Don't take it out of my fucking mouth"? That's
well, I don't understand how it was just.
Don't take it out yet.
That's. I think it's the vaginal.
You know what's okay?
But
can we be like? Can we talk anatomy though? Because if it was in her mouth.
We often talk about that.
Well, how the hell is she talking?
Right. And how were is her legs wrapped around his head? Mm-hmm. Right.
There's a lot of confusing things happening in that clip, and I didn't like it.
Are we not going to talk about collapsing like an accordion?
Right. I liked that.
Bag of milk
in a bag of milk.
They had to be in this position.
You liked Wait. That.
I wish Wait, I had like a sad accordion sound that just went like.
You need to get that, but I want to make this so, like show. Okay.
So
I'm following you. Okay,
so do twos. And now you're gonna do like opposite. Like
so this is.
So this is 69 mm-hmm. in sign language. So like tip to a finger.
Oh,
to
we're learning
your
how
palm.
To do 60. Yeah. She's teaching now, us naughty
but
sign
now
language.
They had
finally,
to, if they're accordion, then you're gonna squeeze your legs. So then technically her legs could be around his head. Right.
So does that mean like her
For
pussy's
our audio
the accordion
listeners,
smashing
we are
his face?
Currently all trying to.
I think so.
You know what? Hold okay. on. Hold on. We'll read this again real quick. Sean, can you read this again so we can
yeah,
get some
you
confirmation?
Read it.
Or no,
I skipped well, a word. I was like, oh,
Jesus
screw that.
Christ.
You read it.
Yeah. This is for science, Sean.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. From Sexes by Henry Miller. Then a groan. A spasm. A wild, tortured look as if her face were under a mirror pounded by a hammer. Don't take it out yet, she grunted. She lay there, her legs still slung around my neck, and the little flag inside her began twitching and fluttering. God, she said, I can't stop it. My prick was still firm. It hung obedient on her wet lips, as though receiving the sacrament from a lascivious angel. She came again, like an accordion collapsing in a bag of milk.
Nope.
It's gotta be that.
I don't get it.
I, you know, listen, I guys, really thought we were talking about vaginal lips, but I'm back to maybe this is 69.
I feel like it's 69.
Are we really gonna try to add logic to this?
This is an example of bad writing, people.
That's the whole point of the segment.
Henry Miller.
I want to know, like, what is that dude's sex
time,
life? All
time, one of the top ones.
Like, what is he doing in his bed?
Listening to accordion music and drinking milk.
Yeah, exactly.
And I mean... And that's still somehow better writing than she gave a hand job so hard that he was like a slapstick comedian just dropping plays. Just like, you know. There it is. There it is, Shonda.
Oh, man. I really hope I don't write like that ever.
So that
right, this, okay, pitch.
Again, these are two of the greatest. Hold on. Molly, these are two of the best authors of their generation. So just think that how low the bar is on writing romance.
Yeah, and yet we all have such a hard time getting published traditionally. It's disgusting. Like, who do I have to sell my soul to write shit like that and get it to sell?
Satan.
Satan.
Damn it. Like, the Alva.
Yeah.
There you go. There's Alva too. Is right. A romance author has to sell her soul to the Alva in order to get published.
It, yeah. Yeah.
Perfection.
That sounds correct.
Perfection.
Oh my god!
All right.
Stupid bug.
So here we go, Molly. We're almost into we're on the home stretch. We have a grand tradition on the show: the 1 second pitch, where you get exactly 1 second to sell your book. You can lie, seduce, bribe, or whatever, threaten the audience, whatever you can do to sell your book in exactly 1 second. And then we'll give you a full opportunity to give a real elevator pitch and knock this thing out of the ballpark, man.
All right, tell me when to go.
I'm going to count you in on my massive delay. Here we go. Three.
Buy my book. That's it. 1 second.
Ooh, a little flag.
Like do it. Shit.
Yeah.
That would have been a good one.
All right. So give us a full elevator pitch, man. Why should people check this out?
Can I hire you guys as a marketing team?
Absolutely.
Don't make it weird. Marketing your books a weird way since 2020.
Yeah.
We won't pronounce the name of your book or the author's name correctly, but we will show a picture of it and put a link in the description.
That's fair. That's, I'll accept it.
Two-thirds of our team are professionals. One-third is not.
You decide who.
That's fine. You always got to have like the wacky one in there. And it's a weird book, so don't make it weird. Weird book. The marriage is beautiful. I'm ready. Wait, you guys should call yourselves Accordion Milk.
Oh, Lord.
That's our band
like,
name.
If you ever had like a team.
Yeah, that's our band name.
Yeah, there you go. Accordion Milk.
Yeah. Yeah, Accordion Milk. Yep.
Tim will be on the trombone or whatever the fuck.
Saxophone.
That's right. Tim's got a boner. All right, here we go. Give us the full pitch, Molly, and tell people why they should buy your book.
Oh, I don't know. No, the Elva, it's a think piece. It's a piece that, you know, if you have theories about religion and about outer space, it's a marriage of the two, and it's just food for thought that what if there was something before the earth and how that kind of plays out in our society now. And, you know, there's the gritty cop, like detective story. There's the love story with the love triangle. You know, are you team Noah? Are you team Charlie? Who's to say? And I don't know. I just want everybody to enjoy this and have a good experience reading it. And, you know, think about, I don't know. It's just one of those pieces that makes you think, like, is it scary? Is it weird? I don't know. I just want people to think and enjoy my book. So buy it.
Listen, I'm gonna take you guys through it. Perfect. Perfect. So Dina, I'm gonna ask you a series of questions real quick. So Dina, you with me right now?
I'm with you.
All right. So Dina, do you like romance?
I do.
Do you like Keanu Reeves?
I do.
Do you like space aliens fighting for the soul of humanity?
I absolutely do, yes.
And do you like strong, compelling, hard-boiled female characters kicking ass?
Do I like myself? Yes.
Perfect. I've got two more questions for you, Dina. Do you like anyone's exes?
No.
And do you like accordion-filled bag filled of milk?
No.
Then you will love The ALVAH by Molly-Jaye Kirchner. Because it is available now on Amazon. It is a kick-ass book. It gets every genre together. It is fun. It is exciting. It's got amazing characters. Guys, you're going to fucking love this book. It's got my seal of approval, and you guys need to check it out. Just don't send any dick pics. That's not going to help anyone. Just please don't.
Don't do that.
Yeah, all no right. Milky accordions.
No milky accordions at all. So Molly, this has been a lot of fun. This has been a good time. We've gotten a little crazy on here.
And we're going to.
And it's our one.
Well, no, I was going to say we're getting together for Thanksgiving now. I mean, we've become practically family. I'm going to send Dina some stuffing without onions.
Yep.
So we're good.
I'm in.
This is perfect. Yeah, this is exactly what we're looking for. We've got a home for our eating holidays. Like, you think we're kidding, but we're 100% bringing this back and eating a mashed potato off. So this is happening.
Absolutely.
Yes, I'm there.
All right, perfect. All right, guys, this has been another amazing episode of the Don't Make It Weird podcast. Molly, thank you so much for coming on here. Guys, again, check out the ALVAH, available now on Amazon. Molly, where can the folks find you?
Find me on Twitter at @WriteMollyWrite. I don't really do a lot with my Facebook or Instagram because I kind of hate them. So just focus on Twitter. Find me there. And if you want to ask me questions, by all means, I encourage them. But no dick pics. I don't want to see that funky thing.
No, play that I'm funky with you. Mules and
play that funky accordion with me. Now that's all I'm going to think of if I ever get a dick pic is that song. I'm just going to end.
You're welcome.
Man.
It makes it okay.
Oh, boy. It's all right.
No, it doesn't. Don't.
It does.
No, don't.
It makes it better, but please don't do it. This has been so fun. Thank you so much for having me.
Hey, and thank
I really,
you
really
on.
Enjoyed this experience. I was so scared.
No, it's been an amazing time. We can't wait to see where you go next and maybe get you back on this show again. Molly, huge fan of yours. And guys, Producer Sean, where could the folks find this episode and all the Don't Make a Weird content?
DMIWpodcast.com.
And by the way, before I actually go any further, because I had to double check this, I just wanted to state for the record that, Molly, our first interaction with each other was you apologizing for sliding in my DMs and not sending me a dick pic, and then me sending you a dick pic.
Yes, it's true. It was Dick, that is Dick very Van Dyke. True.
Dick Van Dyke was the answer. Yes, this actually happened. Yeah, this is a real interaction true. Between us. That is very us. True. Yeah, Dina, mm-hmm. don't judge me. It what is. Are you doing right now?
I hate it, and I
send well, Dick Van Dyke see, pictures as a girl, to people like,
if
I like.
If I come into your DMs, if I slide into your DMs though as a girl, I want to make sure you know that I'm not going to send you a dick pic. I don't have
that's
one,
fair. And that's very and good. I'm not going to go find one. Be very clear about that. Yeah.
Right.
To be fair, well, though, and I don't if
like,
you
like, I like to ask people before I just like come in there because that's I'm all about that consent life.
Yeah. And listen, if you had a penis, we already have established that it's basically a third leg. So, I mean, if you had one, it would be substantial.
Yeah, I have really big legs too, and giant ankles,
13 inches.
So, 13 inches. At least. Oh, they call God. Me the All Rock.
Right. Okay. Oh! Oh! Oh, damn. Molly. Oh, my goodness. So, guys, this has been another great episode of the Don't Make a Weird podcast. Molly, thank you so much for coming on, for being a part of this. Where can the folks find you?
You can find me on Twitter at @WriteMollyWrite.
Awesome. And don't look her up on Facebook or Instagram. She doesn't like it there. Don't slide in the DM.
Yeah, don't.
Check out it's the ALVAH. Yeah, it's a bad time. And you can find me on Twitter at DanQWritesThing. That's DanQWritesThing singular. It's donk.
It's donk.
Molly, tell him it's not dank. Molly, tell him it's not dank. Tell him the Ohio way.
Well, I don't know. I kind of like the idea that it's donk because that's version. Like a booty. You know, like you're just saying like
a badonka donk.
Like I got a donk.
A badonka donk.
I'd say go with donk. Like right, split donk. It down the center. If you don't want to be dank and you don't want to be dank, you're going to be donk.
I like this. She's building bridges.
This is
building
canon
some guardian
now.
Bridges. Yeah, I'm
a donkey kind of.
You know
it.
What? I feel like I've really helped. I feel like I was imperative to the helping of squashing the situation.
We did some real conflict mediation, didn't we? And it's all thanks to you.
Could we have a big group hug?
I mean, I was a psychology major. I wasn't. That's a lie.
You know what? On Thanksgiving.
No, Daniel, your hugs suck.
On Thanksgiving. Oh.
How dare you? How dare you? My hugs are good. I was being respectful the first time. You're going to get a smothering, consensual bear hug next time I see you, and you will understand the magnificence of my
you
hugs.
Guys, I bet he really doesn't, and like next time it's just like a side hug.
Yeah, he's going to be, he's going to overthink it.
You're getting like one of those little boop boops on the back.
The one and a half taps, yeah. even worse, it'll
I've
be
never
hover
felt
hand.
More attacked.
Hover hand.
Oh, the hover hand. Like oh if I boy. Ever meet anyone on Twitter, I'm just gonna hug the shit out of like any of these writers on Twitter and be like, tell Dina that I'm a good hugger.
You should do a running hug, like a running, and then you just jump just in their arms, running. Like,
please don't do that.
Yes.
Like the Michael Scott one?
Yeah.
Yes, do that.
All right, Dina, where can they find you on Twitter?
You can find me on Twitter at DinosaurusD. That's D like D.
There it is.
Producer Sean, where can the folks find you, buddy?
I'll be honest with you. I'll probably go to bed after this. I'm exhausted. But you can find me at Chase Holdew on Twitter.
Oh, guys. All right, guys. Thank you so much for joining us. Again, by the ALVAH. We will love you. No dick pics. Jazz hands, everyone.
Don't Make It Weird. Hosted by Daniel Quigley and Dina Soros. Produced and edited by me, Sean Holden. Music by Amaria. A very special thanks to Molly-Jaye Kirchner for joining us in this episode. You can find her book, The ALVAH, on Amazon.com. Link is in the description. Thank you all for hanging out with us till the end, and we'll see you next week. We love you all.